Today's tale sees us playing Interstellar Transport Company, and today I wanted to have a look at what the AI would do with 25 years to itself. I just left the AI, I bought nothing, no ships, nothing. You can see I've got the 225 that you start with. And we're going to see how poor old Soul System did here, just with the AI doing things. Things aren't looking too bad, so Earth is obviously Earth, you know, it's doing well. It is a Christmas tree of starports, though. That is absolutely monstrous. You can see they fairly much go right around there. They are huge. Demand for dilithium crystals has finally pretty much gone through the roof. Fortunately, nobody's supplying them. Uh-oh, we've got some issues. Got some issues. Food is still in supply. Water, however, has bottomed out. Now, this is probably because the amount that's getting shredded off this planet to feed everybody else is far exceeding their little output here. So, I mean, 690, that seems pretty good, right? Seems like, well, that's not what we were making. We were making 8,000. Now, well, we're in the dump. So, this is probably going to bottom out at some point. We'll see in the next installment of 50 years into the future how well this does. How's everybody else doing, eh? Let's have a look. Let us check out Luna. Luna, unfortunately, is starving to death here. Well, they're actually dying of dehydration. They have a lot of refugees. The AI has not managed to keep a hold of Luna and has just let things go a little. So Luna is struggling with their population. They are getting up there on development, though. They are getting there. But, yeah, they've had quite a lot of famine. So they are struggling just a mite. Mercury became open not too long ago. It looks like our blue company here, the Lunar Excursions, is pretty much running a close to monopoly on this place. There's only a few little bits and pieces coming in. But other than that, they are having some water issues. They have no water waiting. They've got a bit of food, so they're doing okay there. They are fully machineried up. Their development has halted, though, because they are, well, they're having some issues, right? Nobody's getting a drink around there. Mars, where you at, Mars? You want to show us what you've got? Mars is popping along. 65% development. Got a fair bit of population. But once again, the AI is failing just a little on the water supplies. I have a feeling, because Earth is struggling with water, everybody else is going to start struggling with water, which is, it's a little bit of a shame. But other than that, there is quite a few people we want off this planet. They are desperate. Look at all these people. They are absolutely desperate. They're just like, please, put us in some dry hoppers and get us out of here. Because Mars is not the place we want to be. No sirree. Now, for the rest of the solar system, it's quite interesting. In my solo playthrough, some of these other planets opened up. What I have a feeling, I've had to leave this unattended because it has taken quite a while, so I haven't seen every bit of news that's happened, but I have a feeling a lot of these planets out on the rim here, they've been colonized and they have struggled. So you can see poor old Triton here, they're dying. They should have 150,000 people. They are down to 48. They're probably pretty much dead. They will die from this. The AI, it's not keen on keeping places alive. It tries, but it tries too late. So a lot of these places out on the rim here pretty much probably had places, but then died. So if we look at Titan, if we can zoom out a little, if we look at places like Titan, yeah, so we can see that there was, there has been some construction here. They did get around to starting to build things. They were colonized, and then they're dead. Because they had some food issues, and they've got some. They need some NAN stat on consumer goods. Get that NAN in there. And what else have we got? Yeah, so they are controlling most things over here okay. You can see that the Blue Company, I'll show you the financial reports in a second. You can see the Blue Company, what are they called? Lunar Excursions is doing okay for itself. There's a lot of planes, there's a lot of spaceships going this way. But outside of that, some of the other companies are struggling just a mite. And you'll see that in a second. So you can see there's a bit of oversupply for Europa. They're doing pretty good on their food and water. They're getting nan on that consumer goods as well. We don't want none of that nan around here. Hopefully for Europa, maybe if they're lucky, their water supply might kick in, because Earth is not going to handle the jandal soon. They are about to pretty much starve themselves. Io here, they're picking up a little. Io is probably suffering from the fact that it has no spaceport. The AI really doesn't like the spaceport. Everybody's suffering a little through company reputation here. You can see that the zero is kicking butt on most of these planets. So that was Io. Ganymede, how you doing, Ganymede? You're not looking too hot either. You do have a bit of food and some water, but yeah, you just, I think Ganymede died from what I remember. They died and they have repopulated themselves. So they're hoping to get back on the wagon, but I don't think it's going to go so well for them. And Callisto, I'm pretty sure I went to Callisto. Yeah, nobody's doing Callisto. Poor old Callisto. The AI is trying to do its best with some of these rockets here. Maybe it's sending people probably to their death. We send them to Callisto. You might want to send them some food and water there, buddy. The other things that have come about is ships. There has been quite a bit of upgrades here. So if we have a look, we have the old Doings that we started with, but now we have the Doing 409. Look at this baby. Dilithium fuel. Want to go some warp speed? Well, you got it. You have got it now. We got warp speed on this one, so we could be leaving the system. We have some monsters here. We've got the darting, which goes a lot quicker, but look at this fuel usage. My, my, my. You want to use some fuel? This baby burns it like no tomorrow. Pretty cheap, so you got that. The Kyun came in, the KHI came in, I think around 10 years into our AI travels here. Takes a fair bit of stuff here. Nicely done. And then we have the big boy here. Look at this. 110 cargo. Wow, that is a big old truck. I'll show you it in a second, actually. There's one in space that I found. And then we got the 530, which can also do some warp speeds here, so they can get out of system and they can travel the world. Now I'll show you, let's see, up here there's a bit of a party going on. And we'll zoom in on this big old monster here. Look at this. He is ready to transport a few things on out. Look at him go. He's a big old box full of storage. And what is he actually taking? He's taking 110 water. So the AI, well, it's not holding out well. It hasn't managed to leave the system. It hasn't managed to keep most places alive. And it'll be interesting to see how it does in the next 25 years. So I'm going to run this through to 50 years, see how the AI does, but things are looking a little bleak for the solar system. And I'll show you the reports, actually. You're going to have to ignore some of the broken bits here. Obviously, the integers are not supposed to be like this. So this is me down on my operating profits here. I am not making much. Oh, actually, I'm making nothing, right? I've been making nothing for years. But old lunar excursions here is kicking butt. Everybody was kind of just humming along, but lunar excursions is clearly the winner here, which is quite interesting. I suspect it's because lunar excursions has access to more ports, whereas everyone else is kind of lost on the port front and is just not being able to do anything. Income wise, are we gonna change? We'll see if we change. It's a little bit laggy at the moment. It's not quite like in what I've done here. And we can see lunar excursions once again. That income is, well, it's a roller coaster for them. Unfortunately, we can't quite zoom in because this is as close as we can get, but they are making 3.0 to the 08. Anyone who wants to do maths can do maths on that. More than welcome. Everyone else, Asian Space Lines and American Space Lines. Well, Asian Space Lines clearly hit rock bottom there. Company net worth. We'll wait for this one to load up. Come on, company. You can do it. There we go. Same old for lunar excursions. They are making bank here. Everybody else is probably a little bit stuffed through the fact that they really can't make a lot more income. Whereas lunar excursions here can just start throwing money at the wall. And sadly, we have not seen them get out of here. Nobody else has managed to get anything else going. So I think the AI really needs the humans to colonize these planets and keep everyone alive, because at the moment it's a sorry state for a lot of these planets. A sorry state. And with that, we will see what 50 years is like soon. Tune in next time for more adventures of Interstellar Transport Company.